The Creation of the American Pitbull Terrier. Audiobook, Joseph L. Colby. Part 2. My good friend Joe Colby asked me to present a short report on the best pit bull I ever owned. This immediately brings to mind two dogs, namely my old Jack Dempsey, UKC 107-700, and Tacoma Jack, UKC 195-702. While these two dogs are not the same, it wouldn't be fair to praise one over the other. Jack Dempsey, or DMP as he was commonly known, was created by Dr. W.W. Cleveland. He is the son of Black Jack of Tudor and Fanny of Dunable. She was the daughter of Irish dog Jack Sutton. DMP pit weight was 41 to 42 pounds. He was a 100% throat fighter and nothing but death could stop him. He was a cautious and intelligent fighter and a winner of 6 fights in the ring. The first, at 13 months, and the last at 8 years. DMP was a fight stock breeder that has been severely tested. Tacoma Jack was a 51 to 52 pound pit dog, possessed strength I have never seen matched in his weight. He was sired by Butcher of Smith, and his mother was Queen Vic of Gardner. Tacoma Jack fought by biting his chest and stomach, as well as all violence known to a dog. I had it run for an hour with 3 big, tough dogs, and it held up. Tacoma Jack is a winner of 9 fights in the ring and no dog stayed with him 30 minutes and survived. He has not fought for years and retired as a stallion. Brown's Tacoma Jack UKC, 195-702. Father. Smith's Butcher, Mother. Queen Vic of Gardner Estate of L. Brown, Modesto. Biggest pit dog I ever had by J.M. Corrington TTE, he was a dog registered spike of Surangition, UKC number 214-384. Brindle color with white spots. Father, the DYMO of Barn Mother, Jackson is silver. This dog, I believe, was the greatest fighter I ever had the pleasure of beholding. He was smart, he fought his head and throat all the time. I didn't breed this dog, but I traded a good bitch to a man in Alabama for him. He was a 48-pound dog, and in this man's hands, he had fought for an hour and 20 minutes, with 9 scratches to his credit. While it was in my hands, I scheduled a fight with the New Berlin Rodeo Grounds dog. This dog belonged to a very elegant elderly gentleman, Mr. R. L. Breeding, who bought him somewhere in the South and was assured that if he lost a fight with him, the dog would cost him nothing. I had seen this dog win some very tough fights, so this breeding man challenged me to fight my dog, Spike. I readily agreed, if he gained 48 pounds we could do business. He refused to do this as he thought his dog would be weakened to do that weight. So after several days of munching on rags, I told him I would fight my dog, Spike, on his dog and he could bring him any weight he saw fit as I truly believed he shouldn't be fought too much over the top 48 pounds for its own good. So we agreed with that and we put the withdrawal, the fight to be 30 days later. At that time, Mr. Breeding and a Charles Smith of St. Louis, Missouri were good friends and he enlisted Smith's help to help oversee this dog's conditioning and later had him groom him in the pit. It must be remembered that this same Charles Smith had quite a reputation at the time, having won 6 or 7 battles with his dog, Billy Sunday, and his advice on conditioning was not to be scoffed at. When it came time for the fight, this Gene Boy, as he was called, certainly looked very suitable. We had them down around 8 a.m., and believe me, this Gene was hard and aggressive from the start until about 30 minutes. So my dog started on his throat, held until he let go, then wrestled him until he had another chance, and then repeated the same treatment to the end, after about 42 minutes. There were 5 turns, my dog taking all of them, and each time he went a little faster. I believe he could have fought for another hour as he was in very good shape. Spike was finally killed by a farmer. I was conditioning him for another fight and I gave up about 10 days before the fight. I was in a 200-acre cornfield, as was my usual way of giving him his morning work, when he slipped away from me and went to a farmer's hog lot, which was about half a mile away. He could smell a pig from a great distance. When I got there, he was dead. The farmer hit him over the head with a hedge. Needless to say, I was pretty pissed off, but that was all over with Spike. I might add that if he had a gun, he could be doing time at Casa Grande right now. The greatest pit dog ever owned by Pete Donovan, having bred, and sold thousands of American Pit Bull Terriers for over 30 years, it is a difficult task to select the finest outstanding dog I have ever owned. However, I believe the best dog I ever had was Donovan's Patty. About 30 years ago I purchased 4 bitches from John P. Colby in Newburyport, Massachusetts. I sent one of these bitches to Charles Craig, Findlay, Ohio, with the understanding that he would send me a male pup bred from this bitch. Charlie did as he agreed and sent me a man I called Patty de Donovan. When Patty has fully matured, he has been tried and true. Though he was of a quiet nature and unwilling to look for trouble, he would have died had he been called upon to do so. He sired many bloodhounds, including Pilot Eye, who fought McCree's Jim to a draw for $3,000, Danger, the dog that stopped McCully's Tige, Joe Spot, Schuert Stubb, Trahan's Midnight, Grimm's Duke, Myers Mike, Straight's Black, and many others. When Patty was just over 7 years old, I sold him to a man in Birmingham, Alabama for a stud dog. So gone the best dog I ever had, and I hope to have another like old Patty. But it's doubtful, since dogs like old Patty are only born once in a lifetime. Biggest bloodhound I ever had, Morris. For many years I have loved hounds, game birds, racehorses and fighters, and I feel that there is a champion of all champions. Our subject being dogs, describing what, to me, was the most complete fighting machine I've ever looked at through a dog collar. So was a 29-pound female named Nervy that I bought from John P. Colby in Newburyport, Massachusetts about 10 or 12 years ago. She was a dark mahogany brindle with a white head and porcelain blue eyes. She had a very close mate and possessed strength rarely, if ever, found in a 34 to 35-pound dog, and yet, under conditions, would fight for however long the battle had to last. Nervy was announced to face any man or combination of men, and while in my hands she defeated Buther's Crazy Judy in 23 minutes. This battle took place in Louisville, Kentucky on November 15, 1925. Bert Sprague was the referee. On March 10, 1926, I fought her against a dog that was said to be undefeated. This was Bob DeZabel. In 1 hour and 19 minutes Nervy won the fight. Ed Rubel was the referee. In addition to the battles she has won, she has gone through a test that a dog out of 1,000 will endure and survive. I have bought dogs from all over the country and have had many good ones, including Snowball, Man-O-War, Dick, Old Lady, Tornado Jack, and others. But in my life I have only seen one that I considered flawless, namely Nervy. She produced bloodhounds and I saw her spend over 2 hours in the pit and win. Morris Nervy. Curry's Manowar produced in 1914, sire, Colby's Bunch, dam, Colby's Monkey Weight. 36 pounds, created by John P. Colby, Newburyport, Massachusetts. Owned by Lames Curry, Lexington, EY. Curry's Manowar defeated Sprague's Hot Rock in 1 hour and 30 minutes. Fought for 3 hours and 50 minutes until a draw against Bob de Armitage. Prof Spike by Mitchell Prof Spike. There is no doubt that the Prof Spike is one of the greatest and bravest pit dogs of all time. His record proves that he has met and beaten some great dogs representing nearly every bloodline in the country. Mr. George W. Mitchell of Washington, D.C., is very keen on owning this big dog who runs his kennels. I don't believe there is a dog in the country today that has a pit record that can compare to Prof Spike's. Prof Spike fight record. Spike lost to H.O. Solomon's King in 57 minutes. This dog almost killed him. Mr. Turner caught him when he was scratching King. He was staggering, stumbling, and crawling to make the scratch. He fought to a draw against Rab de Schenk in 37 minutes. He fought to a draw against George Sadler's Rip, one of the smartest men in the business, in 1 hour and 23 minutes. In this fight there were more than 100 scratches. There were never two playing dogs matched. Professor Spike stopped these dogs in less than an hour. Thomas Brown Denty's James Junker Pierce's Jack Phillips Black Gold Matthews Barker Henderson's Bugler Smith's Plunger Henderson's Red Dog Grant's Big Joe Lowe's Flash Hydrix Birmingham Jack Monkey's Buck Denty's James Jumbo the Killer Collie's Deadshot 1-2 matches at hands by Ed Martin, known Southern Dogman. He stopped two dogs in one afternoon for the same bet. Terry Barber and Hobo Joe. Hobo Joe UEC. De Barber, 22S633, Hobo Joe is the excellent 41-pound pit dog from California. It was purchased from Joseph L. Colby by Terry Barber of Sacramento, California. Mr. Barber owns several real bloodhounds and among his favorites is Hobo Joe. Hobo is a winner of some tough battles and his last two fights have been official UKC competitions. He needs to win one more contest before he becomes an official record champion. He is a tough biter, good fighter, and game. He is a crafty pit dog who can give and take a lot of punishment. He is an aggressive and steady fighter and always takes the fight to his opponent, whether he is on top or on the bottom. In March 1936, Mr. Barber compared Hobo Joe to PR from Deweese. California Buck UKC number 38277. This contest lasted 36 minutes. Hobo was declared the winner when Deweese California Buck refused to scratch. Casey Lawrence conditioned and treated Hobo Joe while Mr. Deweese conditioned and groomed his own dog. Sat-Tai Lane was the official referee. On May 3, 1936, Hobo Joe was matched against Lane's Wild Flag, UKC number 38130. Hobo won this contest in 191-2 minutes. Mr. Lawrence displayed clever handling in this match, causing Hobo to turn, who asked Wild Flag to scratch. When the referee ordered Wild Flag to scratch, he refused to do so. Hobo was declared the winner. Two laps were done in this contest and both were done by Hobo. Casey Lawrence conditioned and cared for Hobo Joe. Sat-Tai Lane conditioned and manipulated Lane's Wild Flag. F. E. Deweese was the official referee. Mr. Barber says that Hobo is possessed of an ideal disposition. He is very quiet and peaceful all the time. Seeing him at home, one would never think he is an artist pit as he likes to sleep most of the time. He has no value as a guard dog, but as a hunting dog he is unsurpassed. This was part 2 of the Joseph L. Colby audiobook. Sign up so you don't miss the third part. My name is Rodolpho and I thank you all for every like and comment. God bless you all. I went.